Father, make to fail woefully. Every plan of the enemy concerning me and my family in the name of Jesus. Make to fail woefully. Every plan of the enemy concerning me and my family. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, scatter with confusion and fire.
Scatter with confusion and fire.
Every gathering that has spoken against me, or they have deliberated against me, or any member of my family, scatter them with irreconcilable differences, confusion, and fire. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Every trap of the enemy set for me, destroy by fire. Destroy every trap of the enemy set for me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. By the power of the Most High God, I command all arrows of darkness. Shot at me and still stuck on me to be removed and go back to sender. All arrows of darkness have been shot at me and still stuck to me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Let every power of darkness assigned against my finances expire. All powers of darkness. Let them expire. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Help me to fight against known and unknown enemies of my life. And grant me the victory. Help me to fight against all known and unknown enemies of my life. And grant me the victory. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Father, send your angels to every place. My blessing has been hijacked and kept. And let that be quick restoration to me. Send your angels to anywhere my blessing has been kept, that has been stolen from me or diverted from me. And let that be quick restoration. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Please step into every situation and place. I am interested and grant unto me favor there. In the name of Jesus, let that be favorable outcome. Every place I am interested, grant unto me favorable outcome. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Let every conspiracy against me never see the light of the day. And let the conspirators still come and bow to the good results that you will showcase in my life. Let every conspiracy against me never see the light of the day. And let the conspirators still come and bow to the good results that you showcase in my life. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Please lay your hand upon me as it is for Elijah and grant me unusual speed in achievement. Lay your hand upon me as it is for Elijah and grant unto me unusual speed in achievement. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Father, please help me to scream out of my circle of friends, unfriendly friends, and expel them from me. Scream among my circle of friends, unfriendly friends, and let them be expelled. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, lay your hand upon all the people I associate with. Make it impossible for them to be used against me in any form. So let them be used in my favor. Everyone that I associate with, lay your hand upon them. Make it impossible for them to be used against me. But let them be used in my favor. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. cause to blind, cause to be made blind, every satanic eye monitoring my life in the name of Jesus. Every satanic eye, satanic gadget, satanic monitor of my life, let them be blind. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father. In any place, information against me are being recorded. In any computer, information against me are being stored. Let that computer crash by fire. In the name of Jesus. Let that computer crash by fire. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father. Every satanic satellite installed in the sky, viewing the affairs of men, cause to fear concerning me. Let every satanic satellite installed in the sky, viewing the affairs of men, fear concerning me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Please bombard me with distinguishing breakthroughs on all sides. Bombard me with distinguishing breakthroughs on all sides. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Let every weapon of the devil deny of my blessing shatter into pieces. In the name of Jesus, let every weapon of delay blessing be shattered into prison. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Let every power of darkness that have been assigned to stop me on my road to progress be blasted out by fire. Every roadblock on my road to progress, clear out in the name of Jesus. Let it be cleared out. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Let your power come upon me. And let every yoke of darkness in my life be broken off. In the name of Jesus. Release your power upon me. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Every negative experience I may be having now, orchestrated from any coven of darkness, expire with immediate effect. Every negative experience I may be having now, that I'll be orchestrated from the coven of darkness, expire with immediate effect. Let them expire with immediate effect. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying, Father. Please cause to discontinue and be disconnected from me. Any affliction that has been released against me from anywhere in the name of Jesus. Discontinue, disconnect from me. Any affliction from anywhere. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, anywhere my name has been mentioned for evil, or it's been mentioned for evil, or will be mentioned for evil, answer by your consuming fire. Anywhere my name has been mentioned for evil. It's been mentioned for you. Answer by your consuming fire. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Bless every work of my hand and command unusual prosperity for me thereby. In the name of Jesus. Bless every work of my hand and command unusual prosperity for me thereby. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising Father. Please heal this land that I am on and cause me to prosper mightily therein. In the name of Jesus. Heal this land that I am on. Heal this nation and let me prosper mightily then. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, please cause every mouth that has spoken negatively against me to start speaking positively in my direction. Cause every mouth that has spoken negatively concerning me to start speaking positively. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising, Father. Please touch every heart that has my blessing in their custody to say and do what they need to say and do. For those blessings to quickly be released to me. In the name of Jesus. Touch every heart that has my blessing in their custody, in their power. To say and do what they need to say and do. For those blessings to quickly be released to me. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, my pocket, my purse, my bank account. I command you to receive inflow of resources, inflow of money, inflow of currency, local and foreign, in the name of Jesus. My pocket, my purse, my bank account. I command you to receive inflow. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, let every agent or foundational cause or problem operating in my life and family be cleared off. Let it expire. Let it be destroyed. Let it be terminated. Now, in the name of Jesus. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, Father, let any mountain that is not allowing me to see the goodness of God anymore be removed and cast into the sea with immediate effect. Every mountain not allowing me to see greater goodness of God. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising, Father. Please take me to your theater and operate on me right now in the name of the Spirit. And make me whole, spirit, soul, and body. Take me to your theater and operate upon me right now. Make me whole, spirit, soul, and body. Let every weak cell in me receive divine touch. Let every defective organ receive divine touch in the name of Jesus. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praising, Father. I decree by your power into my life, into the life of every member of my family. We shall not die before our time, but live to declare the goodness of God. We shall not die before our appointed time. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. Say, I decree. It shall be well with me. I decree. I am making progress. I decree. I am going higher. I decree. I am living a good life. I decree. Favor is surrounding me. I decree I'm getting better. I decree I'm getting richer. I decree I'm getting wiser. I decree I'm getting more anointed. Decree, decree, decree to your life. Whatever you decree, God will establish. Whatever you decree, the Lord will establish. I decree. The lies are falling unto me in pleasant places. I decree. No weapon of the enemy that is formed will be formed against me shall prosper. I decree, I shall get to the place of my destiny. I decree, the Lord is with me. I decree, all things are made ready for me to enjoy. I decree, I shall be highly favored. I decree, I shall not be sick. I decree, I shall not die before my time. I decree, things are working well for me. I decree, good news I will hear. I decree, great blessings I will receive. I decree, thank you, Father. mighty name we have prayed. Say, Father, please help me, every member of my family and friends, to make heaven glorious day. And with ease in the fullness of our time. Now I begin to thank you for answer prayer. Thank you for answer prayer. Blessed be your name. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Thank you again and again and again and again for all that you have done. You have done so well, and we are grateful. Lord, all these prayer points that we have lifted before you, even before we leave this place, and those that are listening to us online, before they leave where they are, let the answer reach all of us in the name of Jesus. You have credit with us. You are credible. You have integrity. And you watch your word to accomplish it. And you told us that we should call on you and you will answer. We know you have answered. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we are praying. God bless you. Please be seated. Mind your business. Pastor. Passport. Amen. I've been advised to make books. God will help me.
Amen.
One day be one day. Monkey will go market. You need to hear that. Praise the Lord. Mind your business, passport. We are going to be talking about develop your negotiation skill. Develop your negotiation skill. In any business you do, as long as money is involved, there has to be negotiation. No business, there is nothing you do that you will not need to negotiate at one point in time. But it's a tragedy to have good products and to be offering excellent service, but to be rewarded cheaply for it based on your inadequacies in negotiation. And you are doing so much, but you are not able to put your bill in the well of resources to draw out the water of wealth. What is the essence of doing your best and not able to speak for yourself to get the best in return? That is why everybody must learn how to negotiate well. And when you see the scriptures, is full of negotiation. There was a particular time God himself was negotiating with man. He negotiated with Moses once upon a time. He was planning to do something. Then Moses said, Moses was giving him reason why he should not be loved. He allows the negotiation. It's very good. There was another time that he had planned to destroy Sodom and Gomorrah, which he actually did. But Abraham stood to negotiate for the souls of Lot, his family member, and the people with him. You see that in the book of Genesis 18, 24 to 33. Maybe we should read that. At least to buttress the point. Genesis 18. From 24 to 33. Peradventure there be 50 righteous within the city. Will thou also destroy and not spare the place for the 50 righteous that are there? That be far from thee to do after this manner, to slay the righteous with the wicked, and that the righteous should be as the wicked. That be far from thee. Shall not the judge of the heart do right? And the Lord said, if I find in Sodom 50 righteous within the city, then I will spare all the place for their sakes. And Abraham answered and said, Behold, now I have taken upon me to speak unto the Lord, which am but dust and ashes. Peradventure there shall lack 5 of the 50 righteous. Will that destroy the city for lack of the 5? And he said, If I find there 40 and 5, I will not destroy it. And he spake unto him yet again and said, Peradventure there shall be 40 found there. And he said, I will not do it for 40's sake. And he said unto him, Oh, let not the Lord be angry, and I will speak. Peradventure there shall 30 be found there. And he said, I will not do it if I find 30 there. And he said, Behold, now I have taken upon me to speak unto the Lord. Peradventure there shall be 20 found there. And he said, I will not destroy it for 20's sake. And he said, Oh, let not the Lord be angry. I will speak yet but this once. Peradventure 10 shall be found there. And he said, I will not destroy it for 10's sake. And the Lord went his way as soon as he had left communing with Abraham. And Abraham returned unto his place. They struck a deal. Based on the negotiation, in business, you need to know how to negotiate. If he had stopped at 30, he would not have even known that he could go to 20. So there are some things. And one thing about negotiation is that sentiments must be removed. If you are too sentimental, you will not get the best. You will be offering great things for little because in business, in negotiation, you must be street smart. Sentiments removed. That is if the way true negotiation is done. Some nations, there are some people they call negotiators. They pay some people to go and negotiate nation to nation. On the round table, they pay them big money. Because it's not just anybody that can do it. Some people, they are trained to do it. Number one, when you want to negotiate, you have to prepare for it. You don't just bump into a business and start. You have to prepare. Mentally prepare, psychologically prepare. Prepare means that you should know the worth of what you are even talking about. You must have made your investigation. They will sell something, if you are the buyer, they will sell something that is very low at a ridiculous amount for you. You will not discover later. So you don't want to be living in regret. You must find out what that thing goes for, the value of it. And in preparation, you must have in your mind what you are going to be dropping on the table as your own first offer. And your own first offer must be padded to accommodate the ups and downs. You know, things, just like I was telling some people where I went to minister yesterday, everything is not spiritual. You have to be bright, and to be bright, you will lead right. You know, they are reading Bible is good. Bible is even full of, you can see that we brought all this in from the Bible. But there are some people that God has endowed in different areas. Put your pain in their well and draw out resources from what it has taken them 20, 30, 40 years to acquire. And they don't put in books for you to just get. Very important. You pad whatever, you know that the negotiation will still bring it down. That is if you are the seller. And if you are the buyer, you must go down low. So that at the end of I said go down low, somebody was spending. What I mean, you know what I mean, in price. So that at the end of the day, you will now come up high. In preparation, you must know your strength. and the weaknesses of the other party. Whatever divide you are in, whether you are divided, you must know your strength, meaning the quality of your product. So that will be your selling point. Because you keep on throwing, this thing can do this, this thing can do this, so that you are trying to get the person to side the sentiment of the person to come up. That this thing is actually able to do this thing. And sometimes you can add some that is some additional benefit, you know, to be delivered by this thing. You know, we are still going to package it. What other people, which could be very cheap, but the amount that you are adding on it is far more than the added parts that you are putting. You know, all these are negotiation skills. Very, very important. And I pray that the Almighty God will help us in the name of Jesus. Then you have to leverage on the situation that are prevailing, that are favorable. Leverage could be, you have found out that product is in high demand, no supply. That is your leverage. Because it's in high demand and it's no supply. The other leverage on the other side that wants to buy, if the person knows that it is in high supply and low demand, that's another leverage on that side. So you must know each of these things before you put in your offer. And you must also try to have a win-win solution. Win-win solution means that you want the person to also not to rip the person of the money, but there must be something that will benefit the person that you will keep on throwing on the table, that this will do this. In fact, the first servicing, you are going to be doing it free for you. Something that the person that will be parting with the money will be happy that at least this will be done for me too. It is very important. Then at that point, you throw in your offer. And when you are throwing in your offer for some particular product or services, you must put it in writing. Because somebody may say, I did not say that. Well, another time, put it in writing. And that's why I think sometimes they do agreement. I mean, agreement, the lawyer, they will sign it. You know that they don't like, some people came to me for some branding in the church. Two people that, Pastor, we want to go into business, we just want you to be aware of it. I said, go and make an agreement. This one is not, I am spiritual father, but I'm also business oriented. Make agreement, write it, get somebody on your side, so write it. Draw all the conditions. I said, many, you don't use, if it's your brother, yours, I will tell you, if you come to me, go and make an agreement. So that will be the legal tender. If anybody violates it, then it will be clear that, because it's very easy for somebody to say, we did not fully say that at the end of the day. Then you throw in your offer. By the time you throw in your offer, you close the deal. That is negotiation. Everybody needs to know how to do negotiation. In business, it will help your business, it will make you go higher, and it will motivate you to do more. Because when you discover that you are doing so much and they are giving you so little, it demotivates you. You don't even want to do much again, and you are not encouraged. And God will help us in Jesus. Shall rest our feet and pray and say, Father, please help me to always get the best in every negotiation, in the name of Jesus. Help me to always get the best. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Say, Father, grant me the wisdom. One of the things that made Esau to lose out, you don't reveal your weakness to the other party. I'm very hungry. Give me something. That was I've seen this one weekend. Oh yeah, for your birthright. Birthright for portage. Birthright is everything those days.
and he revealed his strength. Ah, this person wants to travel abroad. Ah, he wants to sell the car. Since I know the person's weakness, they will just bring it down. You must cover your own weakness and pretend as if nothing is wrong. That if you want to go, go. Also, some like psychological moves. Open your mouth and pray and say, Father, help me to get the best. Every time in my business. Thank you, Father. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Everlasting Father, we thank you for all that you have done. Receive all the glory. Help all of us to improve in our negotiation skills in the name of Jesus. So that we always get the best out of everything that we are putting forward. In Jesus' mighty name, we have prayed. Let me go down. Thank you.